Hello, my friends of Atari Labs. My name is Saul Montoya. Welcome to this tutorial. Now, what we are going to do is a tutorial of hydrological modeling at basin scale with HHMS 4.5. This is actually a remake of older tutorials, but in this time we have updated the tutorial because HHMS has changed in some parts, so it will be better to do a new video. Okay, so what we are going to do, I hope that you have HHMS already installed on your computer. So what we you will receive in the description of this video this folder, where it has the data for the model. Okay, and this in this folder where you will find also the example model as well, example HHMS model. So let's open the HHMS 4.5. So here, this is the software file, and then create a new. It will be example basin. And it will be located, on here. Example inside example HHMS, and then if we create, let's see what happens. Okay, here it creates a folder where inside this folder it will create all the files related to this folder. Okay, great. So here we have already created our project. Let's go to component, create a basin model. Okay, here on this basin model, let's get a new, and this will be basin one. I always prefer to use particular names instead of or like very something that you can remember, because like it is sometimes if you don't put a name that is particular, what will happens is that you get confused. Okay, so just put something that is as you can be as creative as you want when you do this. Put the name of your basin. So create. Okay, so here we have our basin. This is our basin. What else? So let's continue. Let's view map layer. Okay, view map layers. We are going to add, and where we are going to add from example HHMS, inside here data, and here let's open chip file. We have a Gascancha basin extension, and then we can select the system coordinate, and this is new here, or we can skip. Actually, the model is not your reference, so I think that we can go out with skip. I guess that for some models you will need to select. Okay, well, let's go to add rivers as well, select, and then we move up this one, because otherwise we'll be overlying this, and that's it. Okay, then create two sub-basins. So the first one will be upper basin. As I told you, always look for creative names, otherwise you will on the output it will be very hard to identify which is the basin that you have created. So create upper basin, and here we are going to have a lower basin. Create, okay. And then we are going to define a sink, a source, I mean the outlet of the basin. So it will be this charge point. Let's create this. And then we are going to do a reach. So I mean the reach is for flow routing, so the reach actually is with this one. This is a reach. And this will be a string one or reach one. Okay, great. So let's go to the upper basin. And this downstream is reach one. Great. The area here is 160. The canopy none, the loss method will be SSS curve number, yes, and this will be the unit hydrograph, yes, no, SSS unit hydrograph, the transform method, and the base flow will be recession. Okay, great. Let's go to the loss, transform, and base flow. On the loss, the initial abstraction will be 41, curve number will be 55, and impervious will be 0. And something new about the HEC HMS 4.5 is that actually, and I didn't know that you can do it that in former version, that the decimal separator is the point, okay? That's what I have seen here by default, because before I think that was the comma, okay? Okay, on transform will be standard and the lag time will be 200 minutes. And this is the concentration time, I guess. And on the base flow, it will be 30. And it will be 0.9. And ratio to peak, it will be 0.25. Okay, that's great. So let's go to lower basin. Here on lower basin, oops, sorry. Here on lower basin, the downstream of lower basin is discharge point. Yeah, the area of lower basin is 53. The loss method is the SSS curve number, yes. And this is the unit hydrograph, yes. And this is recession. Okay. The loss method will be, the initial abstraction will be 68. The curve number will be 43. And the impervious will be 0. On the transform, the lag time will be 120. Okay. And on the base flow will be discharge of 21, 0.95 and 0.3. Okay, great. So this is the lower basin. You have already defined the all the parameters. So let's go to reach one, that is this one. In reach one, downstream or reach one is this charge point. And if we are going to use masking them, and those, all of them are routing methods. And then let's go to on routing the masking R K is 1 and the X is 0. In one sub reach. Okay, we can save our project till now. And let's go to. Okay, so look what happens if I change everything is connected, and now I go to components and then I create time series data manager. Components time series data manager. And here we create a new precipitation gauge. Let's say gauge one, gauge one. Create. Okay. And then we close because it will appear here, gauge one. Here on gauge one, it will be incremental millimeters and it will be 1 hour. Okay, great. It will be 1 hour. And that's it. Okay. And then if we expand from here, we see our. This is related to the time of your computer, and this is very tricky on here on this is very tricky here on HKHMS and for the because my the time here appears in Spanish, yeah, and for you it might be the date on your language, okay. However, let's see if it works for. Let's see if that works because, as you have seen, the day that I have is actually in English. So let's see how it works because, at least, let's see if it's independent here, okay? Because it can be dependent. Let's see. I mean, that can arise some issues. Okay, so 0 to the 1st of January at 8. Okay. Okay. And here on the table, let's insert the precipitation, the hour of precipitation. Zero 25, 18, 35. 23. Oops, sorry. 07, 25, 18, 35, 23, 28, 2 and 6. Okay, that's it. Okay, so that will be our first station. And then we create another station that will be station 2, gauge 2. So components, meteorologic data manager, oh, no, sorry. Time series data manager. Create new gauge 2. Create. Okay, and this one will be the same precipitation but with the other intensity. So the first to the first at 8 on the table. Ah, and this will be our. The table. Four, 26, 14, 30, 18, 25, 3, and 4. This is the graph, and that is amazing. Okay, now we create a new meteorological manager. Okay, so components, meteorological model manager, new, and see with met1. Create, close. So we minimize this one and go here. And on the meteorological model manager, we are going to use the metric. I think that these are for radiation, precipitation, specify etogram. Yeah, and replace missing will be set to default. Yeah, this is because the precipitation is from 0 to 8, but we are going to simulate from 0 to 20. So, I mean, it will be 12 hours without precipitation rates, and the default I think is 0. So, okay, so here basins include sub-basins, yes. Okay, basins include sub-basins, yes. So if we type this, if we go here in the lower basin will be the lower basin will be for the lower basin will be for station 2 and the upper basin will be for station 1. Okay, that's it. Save again. Components, control specification management, so this will be control one. So here on control one, okay, so your will be for the first of January. This is in my in the language of and please have a look on this because it will be different for all your depending on your installation or on your Windows regional zone and time format. Okay, 0 0. And then it will be calculated every hour. That's it. Save again. Let's go to compute. Create compute simulation run. This will be run one. Next, it will be from basin one, the meteorological, and the control. Great. So we have created our computational, and then if we go to compute, we have here our run one. Then if we do right click, we can do compute, and that's it. Yes. Well, it was a miracle. We did it right on the first time. So if we can go to results and the simulation, this is the global summary. These are the results for the upper basin. This is the total precipitation. This is the loss, and this is the effective runoff. This is the hydrograph, and this is the recession. Something similar will be for the lower basin, where this is the precipitation, this is the loss, and this is the surface runoff, and this is the hydrograph, where the base flow is minimal here. This is how much water enter from the upper basin and how much water leave the reach to the discharge point. And here we have the discharge point where we see which is the input for from the upper basin. This is the what come from the upper basin, and this is what come from the lower basin. Okay, great. So this is a tutorial. This was an update because GKHMS 4.5 has changed a bit from the other ones. So it will be interesting to see the procedure, but with the real, it will be that will be interesting to see the procedure, but with the real data. With the most actual version, because for us it's really important that you get a great first experience with the software. Okay, so it will be all for me this time. Thank you for following our tutorials, and if you like what we do, share with your friends, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and see you in coming tutorial. Have a great day. Bye bye.